Sundays of all day. I don't know about you, but I know this. I know God has been good to me. Somebody will give him thanks and give him mighty outstretched arm. Thank you for your promises, which are yea, yea, and amen. Thank you. I give you thanks. I give you thanks. I give you thanks. Hallelujah. I came to give you thanks. Mighty name. things. Till I die. I'm not gonna rust out. I'm a wear. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God is so good. He has been so good. Welcome, glory to God, Sunday morning. Hallelujah. Here at the blessing, glory to God, of Abraham. Glory to God, those of you. Glory to God, who are going to be picking this up, glory to God, off our YouTube channel. Welcome to you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We're gathering friends all over the country. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You know, the scripture says a prophet is without honor in his own country and among his own people. Glory to God. I'm seeing miracles,
hallelujah,
signs, and
hallelujah,
wonders.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Now,
hallelujah.
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 You should be,
hallelujah,
this place should be filled with,
hallelujah,
miracles,
yeah,
signs,
hallelujah,
and wonders.
Hallelujah.
Amen?
Amen.
You know, when somebody tells you a testimony, and you,
hallelujah,
talk to them, glory to God, and they having anxiety attacks, being attacked by evil spirits, and you could hear it in their voice, amen, and then prayer is offered, and the word goes forth, and that person no longer has those attacks of the devil, amen, hallelujah, glory to God, hallelujah. I marvel, you know. People talk about commitment, but it's more than commitment, it's dedication. See, you commit a corpse to the ground, you dedicate a baby. Amen? Which means it's something new, it's something that's going forward. Glory to God, and you dedicate that baby to the Lord. Wanna say a good congratulations to Sister Mitchell.
Amen.
She became a grandmother. I don't know if it's a boy or a girl.
It's a girl.
A girl. Okay. Amen. I just saw the pictures, glory to God, that she sent out. And congratulations to her.
Amen.
Glory to God. She seemed to be so excited. And I'm always excited when I see something good happening to somebody.
Amen.
I don't like to hear bad news about people. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Don't go around doing bad stuff to people. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You know, some people, they hate me. They don't like me. They want to see me fail, but I won't. I will not fail.
Amen.
Glory to God. The blessing of Abraham will not fail. Let's go to 1 Kings, the 8th chapter. Glory to God. And let's take a look at 1 Kings 8 and verse 15, I believe, we want to look at. Hallelujah. Glory to God. That should be 1 Kings 8. Hallelujah. 1 Kings 8. We're looking at verse 15. Glory to God. Amen. Thank God for all of you. Listen, I have here please, take a couple of these. Give them to somebody that you know is not in church and not saved. Just ask them to listen to it. Glory to God. Here, take this. Listen to it. Glory to God. Well, how much is it? Well, you just tell them any amount you want to give, if you do want to give, but if you don't, it's free.
Amen.
Just take it. Amen. Some people would take them. Some people will give you a donation, but it's not the purpose of giving them out. It's to see people come to a place of repentance. How many people know what repentance is? That's not snotting and crying. Repentance is when you change direction. It's a change in thought pattern. It's a change in heart. It's a change in the way you go about doing things. Will you ever make a mistake again? Probably. Glory to God. Hallelujah. But God is saying to us, you be confident in this very thing. What very thing? He that has begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of the Lord Jesus. He'll do what?
Perform a good work in you.
God will perform what he started.
Yes.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Look at this. And he said, blessed be the Lord God of Israel, which spake with his mouth unto David my father. Glory to God. And hath with his hand fulfilled it. What happened? Two things happened. God said it with his mouth. He fulfilled it with his hand. So you can count on what God has said from his mouth to be fulfilled by his hand. Not by my hand, not by your hand, but by God's hand. Amen. He said it from his mouth, fulfilled it with his hand. David said it this way. He said, this is the Lord's doing and is marvelous in our eyes. Who was doing it?
The Lord.
The Lord was doing it. What were we doing? Looking at it in marveling. Glory to God. Amen. Are you ready to look at some things, glory to God, and marvel? Amen.
Amen.
Now, I was supposed to have somebody show up here this morning, but, you know, glory to God, I keep praying, keep believing. Matter of fact, the lady called me and said, what time does church start tomorrow? Glory to God. And so I'm looking at one soul per week, which if I win one soul per week, that would be 52 souls in a year.
Amen.
In 2 years, every seat in this place will be filled. Amen. Then you keep doing it, be 50 more. Then you start, you got two services, see? But just imagine if everybody had that commitment or dedication. I'm going to win one soul. You know what? God wants souls win. One. How many know he wants souls to win?
Yes, he does.
So he said it out of his mouth, hallelujah, I'll save you and I'll save your house. I'll save you, I'll save your family. He said that out of his mouth. Are we here?
Amen.
So he's not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to what? Repentance. So if he's not willing that any should perish, glory to God, I'm telling you now, when we care about what God cares about, as individuals, as a church, God will start caring about what we care about. Hallelujah. You know, I come a long way from those peanut butter and jelly sandwiches.
Amen.
And them pack of Wendy's from 7-Eleven. You know, remember they had that 99 cent pack of weenies? You could eat on them for 2 or 3 days for 99 cents. Get you a loaf of bread, you know, of course, some mustard and some ketchup. Glory to God, and you just had to eat them 99. That way, you didn't have to tell, go around broadcasting it. I come a long way from that. A long way from that. But guess what? I got a long ways to go. I am not going to forget what got me to the place that I am. That's why I'm giving him thanks. That's why I'm giving him praise. Amen. Because, man, there was a time in my life when I never thought I would be where I am right now.
Amen.
Amen.
I was down so long, could not hear a song. Darkness covered up my head, and it felt like I was, man, I just never thought I would get up and preach the word again.
Amen.
Only God can tell you tonight that I've been just get on the highway and just drive and cry out to God. But here's what I told him. I never forget what I told him. I say, if you restore me, I'll do this right, and I'll do it with power. So it doesn't make me any difference what anybody else does. I made a vow to him that I would do this right, and I would do it with power. We're not just trying to try some stuff. No, God says, this is it. This is it. This is it. What people don't know is that once you erect a church, that there's an angel that comes and measures the church. He measures everything in it. I'm talking about, well, I ain't never seen that happen. Well, God had told you that that's what's going to happen. You have a toilet seat up on top of the pulpit. What is the toilet doing up on the pulpit? Well, they said to put it up there. Well, he said, well, what did I tell you to do? You know, and we're talking about this, we're talking about praise. We must have praise here. We must have it. There is no other way. Now I pray that everybody here is praying about praise, because you, glory to God, will be better when you come in here. Glory to God, and you can lift your hands and you can wave back and forth and you can sing unto the Lord.
Glory. Glory.
What are you saying? Praise is what facilitates the promises of God, and that's why it is so important. Amen.
Amen.
You know, a lot of places you go, of course not here, you just see a performance. Praise is not about performing. It's not about applause. It's about impact. When David started playing for Saul, what happened? His demons left him. David was casting the devil out of Saul with his music. I can tell you now, the devil is getting into people by music. How many of you know that? Frank Zappa, who is a PhD in music, said, we are going to take music and we are going to control this generation. R&B gone. It's gone. You know that smooth, that stuff that you with your lady and you put on, couple together, they put on, and they, that's And then people have got so anesthetized to it, one young man, I guess about 20 years old, introduced me to his girlfriend and said, hey, this is my bee right here. Man, do you know, I don't care if the woman knows she couldn't whoop you, if you used that kind of word, you was in a fun fight. And they want to trample this kind of garbage inside the church. But praise was meant, glory to God, to facilitate the promises of God.
Yes, yes.
Go with me to 2 Corinthians. No, hold on. I can't go from here yet. Help me back. Help me back out there. Glory to God. I was at 15, right? I got a couple more here. See, I'll be trying to. Since the day that I brought forth my people Israel out of Egypt. Egypt is a type of the world. I chose no city out of all the tribes of Israel to build a house that my name might be therein. But I chose David to be over my people Israel. And it was in the heart of David, my father, to build a house for the name of the Lord God of Israel. And watch what God said. And the Lord said unto David, my father, whereas it was in thine heart to build a house under my name, thou didst well that it was in thine heart. David had a heart to build a house for God. Hallelujah. It was in his heart to build God a house. Glory to God. Hallelujah. This ain't something, glory to God, that's a dream or some crazy idea that somebody has come up with. It's really not. We will, glory to God. I'm talking about the blessing of Abraham, Christian Center Global Ministry, will take shovels and break brand new ground.
Amen. Glory.
And I know what that place looks like.
Amen.
I know the sound of it.
Yes.
I know the structure of it. I know what kind of people are going to gather there. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
You know, we pray and pray and pray and pray. But you know, one of the greatest revelations that I got was to pray against agendas. Because why do people come to church? With agendas. What's the agenda if it's not to come and praise him? I've been thinking about this. Woo, no more titles. Not even for me. Because titles sometimes make people drunk. Glory to God, they get beside themselves. I always say, two problems with authority. Glory to God, people who don't know how to be under it and people who don't know how to be in it.
Hello.
Are you breathing? You say, well, this doesn't come from behavior modification. It comes from the heart. David had a heart to do what? Build God a house. He had a heart to build God a house. He didn't have a heart to come there and watch and see God's house. Let me see you real quick. I'm here to watch. No, he had a heart to build it. His heart was so into building this place until his offering was $32 billion. And you have people who won't even believe God so they can give. Won't step out and say, Father, listen, I want to bless your house. I want to bless your church. Everything is about me. Brother Dixon gave the testimony today about getting a car. And he could have been had that car. But one of his concerns was, I want to bless the church. And if I don't do that at the point I am now, that's what I'm thinking about. So he'd rather go without a car to bless the house of God. Me. Well, yeah, prosperity is good, but let me tell you something. God is not going to prosper you so you can walk away from him.
Thank you. Hallelujah.
Solomon loved God, and he first gave himself to God. Them Corinthians, they first gave themselves to God. Hallelujah. What is a prophet? A prophet is an interpreter of the agenda of God. You look at people and say, God, God in the agenda? No. No. Well, wait a minute. No, that's not God's agenda. That's not God telling you to do that. Who? Tell them to get mad at you. I'm talking about they get steaming hot at you. Glory to God when you say, hey, wait a minute. That's not God. Amen. Well, that's God. Yeah. Yeah. You wouldn't know God if he walked up in a red suit. Go to the next verse. Nevertheless, thou shalt not build a house, but thy son that shall come forth out of thy loins, he shall build a house unto my name. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God is generational. He's generational. If you think when you're coming up here to give thanks and you're investing in your destiny, you are sowing into the lives of your offspring when you're giving God thanks. You are covering them up in blood. You're giving God thanks. Glory to God for them, glory to God, and it goes into and through your loins. It affects generations. David couldn't build because he was a man of war and he had blood on his hands. Nevertheless, what he desired to do, God did in his son. And boy, did they build God a house. They built God such a house until when they brought the covenant, the Ark of the Covenant in, Aaron's rod was missing, and the pot of manna was gone, and the only one who could have moved those things out of the Ark was God himself. So what was he saying? He was saying, listen, this temple is erected, is built, and inside this temple it's going to be my word or nothing at all. Now you can rebel against the word of God if you want to. Right on. You rebelling against the word of God? You think you smart? You're not hurting me. I'll still be here next Sunday, Sunday after that, and the Sunday after that. Because the one I praise, he'll be sitting in heaven. When I cry, he's still sitting there. If I laugh, he's still sitting there. There ain't never a chance God will ever change. He won't ever, ever, ever change. And there's no chance that he'll change. So he's saying, listen, in this temple, in these last days, as the temple is erected and the presence of God, hallelujah, is coming forth to us, glory to God, we better line up and do this thing the way his word say, because he says my word or nothing at all. My word or nothing at all. Now y'all talking about some holiness now. Glory to God. Is my word or nothing at all? You can't come making up stuff. I didn't make this up. No. You do not make stuff. stuff up, glory to God, hallelujah, in God's agenda. The agenda is His. He brought you here for a reason. Have you asked Him? Lord, what you got me here for? What is it that you're trying to do in my life? Because He wants to do something in you. Trust me, it's going to be better. Nothing God tells us to do is for His benefit. Like He needs some. God need, no, God don't need nothing. He say, the earth is the Lord, the fullness thereof, the world and all they that dwell therein, the cattle on a thousand hills belong to Him. He said, if I was hungry, I wouldn't tell you. Can you imagine? Bro Bazemore, if God come tell you, Bro Bazemore, listen, I'm hungry. I need something. Can you imagine God telling you that? Telling me that? Telling any one of us that? It won't happen. Well, you, God need me. No, He don't. Matter of fact, when it comes to praise, He said, if these hold their peace, I'll make me rock star crying out. The rocks will do it. Well, I can rebel, be rebellious if I want to. You cool, glory to God. Just rebel. Let me tell you something about rebellious people. They dwell in a dry land. Rebellion only takes you to dryness. But to be joyful and have a glad heart toward God for the abundance of all things, to get into His agenda and say, Lord, what is it that you're trying to do in my life? I'm a pastor, 10 years. Lady, in an abusive relationship, number one. The guy would take all the money, I don't know what he'd do. But anyway, she was always hungry. Need some food. Need this. Need that. Need this. Need that. Well, she come up out of it. I'm talking about the Lord delivered this lady in a miraculous way. She came up out of it. Her whole countenance and everything just changed. She was out of that abusive relationship. She started looking for her a job. She got a job. And my God, rolling in a nice new car, nice new job, everything was going good. You know what she told me? She said, Pastor, I'm going to another church. I said, well, wait a minute. When you were in the dumps, all this prayer and all of this, you know what she said to me? I'll never forget. I'll ever, ever forget this as long as I live. She said, I never asked you to do that. Any of that stuff. I just told you the situation. And you helped me do it, but I never, ever asked you to do that. If you think people won't hurt you in building the house of the Lord, so many people out there drunk this morning from church hurt. I just refused to have it. I just let it run off of my back like water, because you better be able to do that. Glory to God, because you're going to have your Peters that deny you. You have your Judases that betray you. I'm talking about Judas. Judas said, wait a minute. Is this man talking about dying?
Yeah, he talking about dying.
Judas said, well, this is coming to an end. I better see what I can make off of him. Because it won't be no more treasury. Because that's what he was doing. How many know what he was doing with the treasury?
He was stealing. And then he got offended. He got offended because Jesus told him, no, we're not going to sell this expensive oil and feed the poor. No. Do you know what the scripture say? It was right at that point that the devil entered into him. The strangest thing about the devil is that he'll get in somebody and think that nobody see him in him. Because he's a deceiver, and when somebody walks with him, they're deceived, right? Let me tell you something. I can tell you something about the blessing of Abraham, Christian Center. When you come here, you will go right to the Word of God, and you can look at it for yourself. And you can see it, you can believe it, and you can become it. So, if you're the enemy, guess what? I got to get you out of here. I've got to get you away from this Word. I have to take you away from this Word. It ain't about no personality. It's not about me. I told you what I was. I told you I begged God, restore me, put me back. Glory to God. I just study. That's all I do. I study. Glory to God. I get up in the morning, preach for an hour at 10 o'clock. Glory to God. Go back three nights a week, preach for 2 hours. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That's three hours some days. Glory to God. And then on Wednesdays, it's 4 hours. Just boom, 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 boom. Like a machine gun. People say, what? Man, you could. I can do that. No, you can't. I shouldn't even say you can. You can if you study. But without the discipline of studying, let me tell you something. If they locked you in the jail and said you must pray for 2 hours to get out, being that frozen bologna and the frozen cheese, and if you don't know how to light no fire on that cell, you're in a whole bunch of trouble. I mean, that meat, that bologna had ice on it. I'm letting the cat out the bag. God say, how you know how to do that? It just makes sense, right? Take this toilet paper. Give me some of that toilet paper. Start pushing that toilet paper down in the thing. Push it all the way down in that hole. Just keep putting toilet paper in there. Now light the toilet paper. And what's that supposed to do? Roll a bologna over the top of the fire, and that'll melt that ice and cook your bologna for you. If you had to be in there, glory to God, and pray for 2 hours. How about if they say, you better pray for 6 hours or you not getting out of here? Oh, man. I'm going to be in there for a long time. Glory to God. Pray for discipline yourself in the things of God. You know, people want to do outstanding stuff and they just think, well, poof, it's just going to happen. Poof, it's just going to happen. I know people get up 4 o'clock in the morning, waking up that early for to pray. You woke? Yeah, pray. Doing what? Praying. You'll be surprised some of the revelation that come to you for spending time with God in the morning. See, David understood what praise was, but he introduced into, glory to God, human existence, praise for warfare. And because of his warfare, he could not build. Hallelujah. One of the characteristics of the prophetic ministry is warfare. You won't catch it, you're not supposed to anyway, catch a prophet that doesn't do warfare. They're warlike. Nice people. Some of the ones I met, they're nice people. But when they start praying, they're very dangerous and warlike. When they start praising, they're dangerous and warlike. He says Solomon is going to build. But the point that I'm making here, and how am I doing? Ooh, I'm doing good. I don't know what happened to my clock. It disappeared. They didn't tell me it had legs on it. It was pretty nice, but nobody said, hey, Pastor, watch that thing because it got legs on it. But anyway, let's keep going. Hallelujah. Go with me to 2 Corinthians 9. 2 Corinthians 9. Let's go down to verse, let's start at verse 8, 9 and 8. And who?
God.
Is what?
Able to make all grace abound toward you.
How much grace abound toward you?
All.
He gonna tell us how to get that to start flowing until it all just keep coming toward you, toward me. God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you always having all sufficiency in all things may abound to every good work. Grace is not abounding toward you, glory to God, so you can catch, glory to God, the next Boney James concert. God's not blessed. He's not giving you money so you can do that. You may have some left over where you could do it, glory to God, but the primary purpose is for you to do every good work. Are you hearing me? Every good work. All grace abound. I mean, come on, man. God is able to make what? All grace abound toward you, that you always have what? The sufficiency in all things may abound to every good work. Keep going. As it is written, he has dispersed abroad, he has given to the poor, his righteousness remaineth forever. Now God take the poor and the needy from the dunghill, and he raises them up and causes them to sit with princes so that the glory can be given to him. Now you came from the Rockefeller family or the Kennedy family, glory to God, you say, well, I inherited my wealth. Glory to God. But when you came from the Daniels family, glory to God, hallelujah, you rich, you can't do nothing but give God the glory. Hey, glory. Thank you.
Thank you.
Did you hear me?
Thank you.
I've seen days, let me tell you something. We were, first of all, we was in the ghetto. Then we moved from the ghetto to the projects. It was eight of us. If Brother Cleary ever come here and preach, I'm gonna have y'all look at that scar on his hand. That scar came from him trying to get his brother pork chop so he could sneak a piece of it, and he got stabbed with the fork. Fork just went, that brother caught him with the fork. Hallelujah, over there trying to get a piece of that pork chop. Now these were big guys, you know, they about 6'5", all of them. Glory to God. I'm talking about all of them were just giants. So you can imagine trying to take that man pork chops, especially if he had been to school playing any kind of sports. He was hungry when he got to the house. And wasn't no two pork chops to go around. Glory to God, you got your one, and that was it. They put it on the table, and you tell me, I don't want that. Well, you're going hungry until tomorrow, where maybe you get something that you like. So you get used to all kind of things. Man, I ain't like no pinto beans, but praise God, hallelujah, it was pinto or nothing. So it was pinto. Are you hearing me? I look back on those days, and that's why I say thank you. That's why I say thank you. I don't have to put that ski mask on anymore. Hallelujah, with that pistol. I don't have to rob nobody anymore to get it. I can pray. I can praise. I can go in the Word because the God that I serve, glory to God, hallelujah, is causing all grace. I'm talking about all grace. All grace. The prophet, not this Thursday, the Thursday before. The prophet came on and the prophet said, he gave me a prophecy. This was about 7 o'clock in the evening when he prophesied to me. He'll be here next week. He prophesied to me. You want to bring a guest next week? This guy's, I'm talking about, he gave me a prophecy at 7 o'clock in the evening. And when I went to bed, by the time I woke up at 6 o'clock in the morning, that prophecy had been fulfilled.
Amen.
I ain't talking about no peanuts either. I'm trying to tell you, we are living in a place right now, glory to God, where there's an outpouring of God, glory to God. Don't be like them 380 people who left the upper room. And the presence of God came, the power of God fell. And Jesus had appeared to 500 of them and told them to wait. But when the day of Pentecost came, it was only 120 of them. Wonder where the other 380 was. Do you understand? Are y'all getting this? He, watch this. Now he that ministers seed to who?
The sower.
So if you're not a sower, God is going to give you seed. There's no need to get no seed if you're not going to sow it. What are you going to do? Put the seed in the drum? So I got a bunch of seed in there. But you know, if you plant that seed, you'll get a crop. No, I didn't know that. I'm just keeping my seed. So what are you going to get somebody seed like that for? He gives seed to the sower, both minister bread for your food, and multiply what? Your seed sown, and increase the fruit of your righteousness. He said, I'm not only going to increase the seed that you sow, I'm going to increase your lifestyle.
All right, thank you.
Didn't he say it?
That's what the word says.
Jesus shall bring forth fruit unto righteousness. People say, oh, no, you done went off now. I ain't went off. I didn't go off. You can take money and determine what go on in heaven. I didn't come up with that. I didn't make it up. God said it. God said, listen, if I give you a dollar, you bring a dime back to me. And so a diamond back to me. He says, you're going to start stuff to happen in heaven. What's going to happen? The window's going to open. And what else is going to happen? I'm going to pull you out of blessing that there's not room enough to receive. Now, if you go back up to this seventh verse, watch this. Watch this. Y'all here? Mm-hmm. You got to put, you got to start naming and understanding why you're sowing into the kingdom of God. I'm not trying, I ain't asking for no money. I'm just trying to tell you what this does, okay? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Every man according as he does what?
Purpose.
In his heart.
Long as it's not unrighteous. I'm telling you right now, I was on the phone last night, and what I thought would just be, Brother Dixon, I thought it would be way out. Oh my God. And it was broke down real simple to me. You can do this, do that, and you'll be in the place you want to be in. What? You mean to tell me? You mean to tell me it's going to be that easy? Yeah. One, two, three. Why? Why? I'm purposing in my heart. I'm purposing in my heart that one Sunday, y'all gonna drive up here and it's gonna be them beautiful awnings out there. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Burgundy. Written on it. B-A-C-C-G-M. And y'all gonna be like, whoa. The rest of these windows tinted. Glory to God. A good, hallelujah, HD camera in this place. Glory to God. Souls coming from the north, from the south, from the east, and from the west. You can't make me doubt that. You can't beat it out of me. I get up, come here, Wednesday, I come in faith. I come here Sunday, I come in faith. I said, well, you know, this lady right here, boom, 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 she's a multi-millionaire. I'm not asking her for no money. I don't know how to beg. Beg, I don't know how. Why? Because the Lord is my shepherd. Glory to God. And I shall not want. David said, I once was young, and now I'm old. I never seen the righteous forsaken, nor the seed begging bread. Huh? Never! You mean never? Never. Never. Never.
Never.
I forbid lack to be in your life from this day forward.
Thank you.
I forbid it in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
I forbid it in the name of Jesus.
I thank you.
Don't play around with no devil. You devil of lack, I bind you. I command you to take your hands off. This is a house of abundance. Our God is a God of abundance. We speak it into the life of every person, hallelujah, in this room. Every person looking at us, hallelujah, through YouTube. We break the power of lack and insufficiency in Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
It's broke. I'm telling you now, it's broke. Let a man do what? According to the purpose of the heart. So let him do what? What's your purpose in your heart? I ain't just trying to see. What you throwing seed for? And you expect no harvest. What is you doing? You a farmer, planting seed out there, and ain't expecting no kind of harvest. You just got the tractor going out there, tearing the soil up, putting seed in the ground. I ain't expecting nothing. You religious devil, I bind you in the name of Jesus. Talking about, you know, no. He gives seed to me because I sow. He gives bread to me because I eat. He caused all grace to abound toward me, that I always have the sufficiency in all things, and I'm equipped unto every good work.
Amen.
Yes.
God will have rolls of money in your pocket so big it'll choke a government horse.
Glory to your name. You are an awesome God.
They could go in, oh God, I've got a big mouth. Hallelujah. Huh? Let him give what? The way he purposed in his heart. What are you purposing in your heart? Why are you investing in the kingdom of God? What is it that you want done that only God can do? Purpose something in your heart. Just be this. I'm going back blind. Ain't no such thing as no blind faith. Huh? Brother King, you do it with a purpose. See that you walk with a purpose. And release the promises of God. Okay? Not grudgingly or of necessity.